morning, boss. Jeff here. Thanks again for bringing me on board. You've found a lot of talented people for this team. I can't wait to see what we can accomplish. Our journey to the Constructors' Championship starts here today, and the car is ready to head out whenever you are. The fastest lap of the session so far.
Session has drawn to a close, so let's review our top three.
Bottas, Verstappen, and the owner driver.
Sadly, it's time to say goodbye as free practice is over. However, we'll be back shortly for more Formula One action.
Any of our standard programs over the course of practice. It'll be a boost to car development if we can log that data, so we should do our best to do so before the end of the session. T15, it's a very tight left-hander. You will understeer if you take liberties. okay, this is a quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat. Program complete and a job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can talk you through the numbers. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:29.8.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. The owner driver, Hamilton, and Max Verstappen. And that's it. Practice is officially over. Until next time, goodbye. We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Hamilton, Verstappen, and Valtteri Bottas.
Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. No more testing, no more practice. This is the real deal. And it's make or break here at Albert Park, home of the Australian Grand Prix since 1996. And home to round one of this year's Formula One World Championship.
Just south of Melbourne's downtown business centre is the one and only Albert Park Circuit. 3.3 miles of public roads, closed for the weekend of course, make for a bumpy circuit with little undulation. There are 16 corners around the lake and a couple of good passing opportunities here as well, thanks in part to the DRS zones into turns 1, 3 and 13.
Can Mercedes start with victory in their bid to win a seventh consecutive Constructors' title? Could Ferrari or Red Bull establish an advantage early on? And with 22 cars on the grid, how quickly can the new team find their footing? Well, it's great to be back, Anthony Davidson. We've got a lot to talk about this year.
That's right, Crofty. It felt like a long winter, but it's good to finally be back. I have to think the usual suspects will battle it out at the front. But there are always going to be some teething problems early on in the season, so whoever can keep on top of their issues will have the advantage today.
As I mentioned earlier, we're up to 11 teams this season, with a new entry run by, well, of all things, an owner-driver. That's something we haven't seen in this sport since Hector Rabac over four decades ago. So how are they looking so far?
It's hard to imagine how a small operation like that could survive in the ruthless world of Formula One. And yet, here they are, first ever race, looking surprisingly strong. But there are no points for qualifying. Let's see how they fare in the Grand Prix proper.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, the owner driver, Sebastian Vettel and Norris, Leclerc, Albon, Sainz and Daniel Ricciardo, Perez, Ocon, Lance Stroll and Magnussen, Grosjean, Raikkonen, Pierre Gasly and Daniel Kvyat, Schumacher, Giovinazzi, Russell and Nicholas Latifi. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
You've got a lot of spare energy. Use your overtake button. Nice work. That brings you up the place. The fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. The car behind has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. Some information on Norris. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. sensor teammate behind is 21.5 seconds. Push now, we're boxing this lap. Issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Yellow flag. The incident has been cleared. Let's get back up to racing speed. Go, go, go. You'll be racing on the exit. Complete. Go now. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. That front wing, it'll need replacing if it takes too much damage. D gap to the car behind is 2.2 seconds. We're leading our teammate by 32.1 seconds. Five laps of fuel remaining. Dropping a second a lap to the car behind, 1 second. just 3 laps of fuel remaining. The teammate behind is 37.0 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. Some information on Verstappen, they are out of the race. There's only 1 lap of fuel remaining. Nice work, that's P1. Race win, well done.
Another superb Australian Grand Prix comes to an end, and it's a thoroughly deserved victory. Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today. What set them apart from the rest?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.
Let's have a look then at the driver's standings. After today's impressive result, we have a new points leader. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, Lance Stroll would be my pick. He managed to keep a cool head today whilst pushing through the field. I know that's at odds with the official decision, but I think they deserve some recognition on a day where both of these drivers are at the top of their game.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.